is that my wife ran into one time, and maybe I'll tell that story very quickly. So, she said they were leaving the supermarket store, and some grungy homeless guy looked at my daughter, who was quite young, and just kind of energetic, and he brought me around, and he said, oh, she's got that Bible energy, she's got Bible energy. I mean, I've never heard that term before in my entire life. It's a very odd term, but... And then he starts talking to my wife about all the night your kids celebrate Halloween. He's like completely out of the blue. And then she says by the end of the conversation, this homeless guy is giving my wife money, telling her to buy Bible with it. And it's like, wow, is he one of the most unique homeless people on the planet? Or that was an angel just having an interesting way of trying to encourage my wife and my family.
You might be right, kid. Yeah, it might have been an angel. I agree. Let's roll into the bottom of the hour here and back with more calls, more conversation with Ken and me. Hey, to the elephants, it ain't no rest for the wicked on Coast to Coast AM. Yeah.
Start or advance your IT career. IT keeps growing. Don't go to the pros. My computer career. The right training, the right time, the right. Itself.
Other theories or arguments against that are ultimately pretty weak, and they fail because that's kind of like well established. So now we have them being born out of the union pre-flood. Okay? Well, that's actually very important. They live pre-flood, and then the snake does not surprise them physically whatsoever. And again, if you're reading a version that uses the word giant in Genesis 6, you cannot just commit a word concept fallacy and merely assume that it's telling you something about their size. It's not. And if it is, you're not going to know what that size is, because you have to now invent what is meant by giant. Okay, even if you think it means something about height, a few inches taller, a few feet taller, a few entire body length taller, you're not going to know. So anyhow, now we have the flood happening after Nephilim are created, but then what happens to them? Well, by definition, the last of them would have drowned to death. Period.
Right.
That's end of story. They're dead and gone. That's it. Any concept of survival of Nephilim contradicts survival by time, and any concept of their return at any time would imply that God failed. Right? If he meant to get rid of them, they were part of the generation of the flood, and maybe, you know, God couldn't get the job done. You know, he must have missed the loophole. And the flood was really much of a waste, because the next thing you know, boom, Nephilim somehow, according to whatever dog tail someone is going to invent that's not biblical, they're back. You know, they're back. So, what we actually have happening is that in Numbers 13, we get a narrative about reconnoitering the land of Canaan, right? So, the spies are sent into the land, 12 of them,
right?
And they go around the land for some 40 days and come back. The main body of Israelites and report what they saw. So what happens is that a report is presented to them that is accepted as is, and it's a report about how, well, there's a lot of people who grew up in the land, and they're strong people, and they live in big fortified cities. So when you're in part of a group of